as the global champion for COP23, it is one of our responsibilities, together with my co-champion, Madame Elaite of Morocco, to enhance partnerships between parties, meaning governments, and of course we also have regions, we have states, we have towns and cities, we have communities, we have the civil society, non-government organizations, faith-based organizations, and of course individuals.
In COP, under the Fijian presidency, we are going to discuss our common future. That's what COP23 is about. And this means it's the future of our kids, it's the future of our young generation. And Uniting4Climate can provide this type of voice for the youth to make the COP23 really a place where people feel that they can make a difference and increase the pressure on the decision makers to be ambitious in faster implementing the Paris Agreement.
It's really that underlying message that we need to go further and faster and we need to do it together.
This generation had something that we didn't have. So they have a tremendous capacity to enter in contact with the others. This is very, very, very good. So this is a way they can also be behind the government pushing them. Everything will be discussed. It will not impact us in the short period. So every sacrifice we do, every financial engagement, will not give you the result tomorrow. So the people has to be convinced, has to be participating in the decision-making process, because it's something that we are looking forward.
This is not only about today, it's about them and the future in terms of sustainable development. And we urge all our youths to again plead with their leaders, and of course not only pleading with their leaders but take responsibility, be involved.
Each individual, no matter where we come from, what kind of background we have, cultural background or religious background, that all we can make a difference if you really join efforts.
In Uniting4Climate action, whether we are big emitters or whether we are small emitters, whether we are a rich country or we are a least developed, developing country, we are all vulnerable and we must all act. That's very, very critical. Because for us, as a small island state, mitigation is critical. It's important because it's a matter of survival. It's a matter of survival.